Hi guys, Dave here. Dave's LFC Chats. Okay, as you've seen in the thumbnail, prediction time Premier League 19-20 season starts next Friday week against Norwich at Anfield, 9th of August, and it's straight through, bang. Okay, still another week left in the transfer window, so anything could happen there. A week left. We shall see what happens. I'm not holding out hope for Liverpool, though. So I'm going to put a prediction in now with a week to go on the transfer window. So anything could happen still. But as things stand, let's say, I'm going to give you the top six and the bottom three to get relegated. The meat in the middle doesn't matter. Who cares less about that? It's really the top six and the bottom three that really defines the Premier League season, unfortunately. So you have to look at the Premier League. Our pre-season's been poor. We had a good win against Lyon yesterday, 3-1. But, you know, there's loads of bits of news as well I'm going to go through as well, just before I give you the Premier League top six and my last three. The five young players have been sent home from the camp in Evian. The likes of Larouche, the likes of Sepp Vandenberg, Lewis, Duncan and Elliot all sent home today for more training. It looks like the 29 went over, 5 sent home, so 24 man squad left, minus Mane in the mirror. Of course, he has to still come back. He's the only one who hasn't kicked the ball yet, come back from the African Nations. But it looks like, I think that's going to be the core for the 20, that's going to be the Champions League a team, plus Mane of course, to go into the Champions League. So those 5 young lads, I don't think will get much first team football next season. I could be wrong, but a bit young. He's just giving them the taste in the pre-season, but I can't see them being involved too much next season. I could be wrong, guys. You never know, but I just can't see it. Injuries and stuff, depending. But I think they'll more go through the League Cup. I'd play them the League Cup. I'd play the whole lot of them in the League Cup, to be honest with you. But that 24 core that's left behind now, the likes of Brewster there, and the likes of Oxlade-Chamberlain, that really should help us going forward. But really, really, guys, you'll know with my predictions, we really should be signing a player. We've a week to go, you never know, but you have to sign players when you're on top. All the top teams did it. All the top United, Chelsea's, the Barcelona's, the Madrid teams. You have to buy players while you're on top. That's how you win things. That's how you stay on top. Because all the rivals behind you, keep buying and stay on top. And as soon as I talk, a helicopter's going to go by. It's probably Klopp on board with his camera looking down at me. Hi, Klopp. But anyway, so we didn't buy anybody of significance. Brought in a few youngsters like Elliot and Sepp Vandenberg, but we didn't really. Fernandes still holding out hope there. Arsenal signed Pepe today, which is a huge deal for them. Congratulations to Arsenal, because I would have liked him at Liverpool, but we didn't get him. I don't know, still rumours about maybe Lovren going to Roma, but I don't know. I can't see, unless Klopp has a ready-made coming in, I can't see him going anywhere. There's only a week to go, guys. But anyway, we get back to the top, the predictions. Now, as things stand, with a week to go in the window, I have to put City down as favourites again. I mean, they've strengthened with Rodri coming in and one or two young lads. But the squad they have, okay, there is a caveat about Sané going to Bayern Munich. I'm very surprised if you do let him go. He's brilliant. He's a really top player. He's a player that comes off the bench and usually scores against Liverpool, of course, but he's the type of player Liverpool would love. But that will weaken them if he goes, definitely. It'll equalise it out a little bit more if he goes, but let's see. There's a week to go. But still, City are favourites. I was hoping for one or two signings. It hasn't happened as of yet, but at the moment, City are slight favourites for the league, has to be said. They have a magnificent squad, a better squad than we have. When the two 11s are playing each other, there's not much in it, of course, but it's the squad that wins your leagues, unfortunately, over a long season, as we've seen last season. So I have Liverpool second place again, but you never know. It's going to be tight, Liverpool City. I have Spurs again. Spurs have bought well, and they're looking for Fernandes here today as well. So if they get him now, new stadium, I think Spurs will finish third. Now, it's going to be interesting. You'll have Arsenal and Manchester United fighting for fourth. Now, depending on who comes in the next week, the likes of Maguire, maybe to United, I still think Arsenal need a defender or two. The defence is still poor. But United could get Fernandes, Robin from Spurs, could get Maguire. Lego head, we shall see. So as I said, the predictions are a bit early. They could change next week because anything can happen in the transfer window. But at the moment, I'm going City, Liverpool, Spurs, and I'm going to go for United. Although I hate them, I'm going to go for United in the top four to get Champions League football next year. Arsenal just to finish fifth, and Chelsea, who of course had an embargo against them, but have still have a good squad. And Pulisic came in as well, but they lost Hazard. That's a big loss to them, so they will finish in the top six. Remember, Everton, Wolves, Leicester, all to run, you know, that 7, 8, 9 position, close to 6. That's the top 6. Bottom 3, unfortunately, Sheffield United come up and they go straight back down. Norwich City as well, I think they'll go down. And Brighton. They're the 3. I think Villa will stay up. They spent over 140 million or something. Big team, big crowd, big fan base. I can see Villa staying up. It's bottom 3 for me. Sheffield United, Norwich City, Brighton, in that order, unfortunately, to go down. Could be wrong, it's only my opinion. Let me know what you think your top 6, bottom 3 are in the comments, and your opinion as well. We shall see what happens, guys. But as I say, at this moment in time, the 1st of August, I just have City slightly ahead of us again by a point or two. If we sign someone like Fernandes, maybe a little lovely little present in the back door, things could change. At the moment, we just haven't delved in. We have the money, remember. We have the money. A lot of young players, a lot of potential. We're in a really, really good place. Melwood, of course, was sold for 10 million today. Melwood, of course, we only have one more season left at Melwood, the training facility. I'm going to move to Kirby next, starting next season, season after next. Brand multi-purpose facility where everything is housed together, which I'm looking forward to that as well. But Melwood will be gone and is sold today, and housing is going in there. So an end of an era at Melwood. That's about it, guys. We shall see. Things could change. A week to go on the transfer. Big game Sunday. Liverpool against Manchester. Shitty Visa card boys. Charity Shields. Only the Charity Shield, but I don't want to lose. I hate losing against them. Even play Tiddlywinks, I wouldn't like losing against them. But I really do think we're missing a trick if we don't bring at least one player in. I really do. Maybe an attacking midfielder or striker or something like that. Timo Werner, maybe. You never know. But it's my opinion. We shall see. That's what football's all about. Opinions. This means more. I'll talk to you soon, guys. This is what it's all about. Don't be too downhearted. Don't be too despondent. We are in an unbelievable place. Number 6 in the bag. European champions, remember. We've Champions League. We've Super Cup. We've World Club Cup. We've the Premier League to go for again. League Cup and FA Cup thrown in. There's going to be a lot of football. There's going to be a lot of chances. We've a really good squad. It's going to be tight between Liverpool and City. There's a week to go on the transfer window. I'll talk to you soon, guys. This means... more. See ya.